All right, looks like we're live, everybody. Welcome to HeyRiverside.com. Boom.
Boom. Boom. Hi, everybody. This is Rick with Extraordinary Culture Podcast, and I'm here with Ralph and Patrick of Hey Riverside as well. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Hey, thanks for having us. This is pretty cool.
This is awesome.
I don't think we've ever done like a cross podcast thing before.
This is something we've been talking about. This is our 1 year anniversary as well, so thank you for listening for the last year. And we're just sitting down with one of our sponsors of Extraordinary Culture Podcast, Rico Alderetti. He is the owner of Made.Shop here in Riverside. Thank you again, Rico, for being a sponsor.
No problem.
And we're excited to have you here. First off, congratulations. You were the recent recipient of an award here at the City of Riverside. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, the Pitt Group Award is a small business of the year. We're very honored. It's a bunch of young professionals in Riverside, and they elected us to be a small business of the year. It's a pretty big honor.
That is awesome. So tell us a little bit about the shop and what makes it unique and what makes it a great place to come by, especially right now. The holidays are coming up.
Well, the holidays coming up, unique gifts. It's the best thing for that. But the make of the store is, we just figured it out today. We have 116 makers and artists right now in the store. Majority of that, I'd say over 90%, are local. And we give them a place where they can make anything from jam to ceramics, industrial lights, furniture, all kinds of things, robots, anything. If they make it, we'll give them a place to sell their stuff.
I know there's plenty of things in my home from here already. so 116 makers. How does that work? If people are interested, can they come to you still?
Yeah, you can contact us on Facebook or Instagram, or come on down. We really like to suggest you come down, get a feel for the store, and see what we have. And that's the best. That's like been the sellers. Most people are like, oh, I don't know. But they come down and look at the store and they go, all right, I want my stuff in here.
That's cool. And you said about 90% from Riverside, so a lot of local clientele?
A lot of local clientele and vendors, yes.
Yes. Now, this is not just what you do. I know you do the local artist stuff. You do the craft makers and things here, but you're also part of, for lack of a better term, a network of small businesses, right? In terms of like the Magnolia Center Marketplace.
So we do organize the Magnolia Center Marketplace, yes, where we shut down Sunnyside. We're a fair weather market. We'll start back up in March. We have food and vendors and entertainment for the kids. It's always changing. That's also a lot of local vendors there. We also offer custom furnishings and just kind of, we always kind of say, if you dream it up, we'll build it kind of things. With over 100, with 116 makers, we can a lot of times collaborate together and make cool stuff. You know, there's woodworkers and there's iron workers and there's glass people and there's ceramic people. So if you have it, we can get everybody together and kind of put it together.
Are there some of your like particular favorite pieces you guys have done as these collaboration pieces? You're talking about your consignment type pieces where you will design and build these unique pieces, or anything that stands out?
What stands out really cool is we transformed someone's extra room into an industrial canning room. It was just an extra room. We put copper on the ceiling, steel on the wall, some live edge tables, live edge and concrete. And the reason it's dear to me is because my background is using a union iron worker, and that job right there really kind of, about 2 years ago, stepped back and let me actually start focusing more on the store, the Magnolia Center Marketplace, and doing custom stuff. That's one. On the unique thing, that someone came and they wanted a centerpiece out of Rapunzel, I think it was, like the boat on Rapunzel.
Okay.
Was it Rapunzel?
No.
It was a Disney movie, I'm sorry. But one of the ceramic people, they built a big, it was for a quinceañera, and they built it for them. And so it was kind of cool. It was like they couldn't find it anywhere, and they said, do you have someone that could do this?
Yeah. So now I'm starting to think Moana, as you're saying this morning.
Moana?
Was it Moana? Like the Hawaiian style?
No, it wasn't Moana. It was it was like a little,
It wasn't Coco, was it?
It wasn't Coco.
I can't remember.
Rapunzel makes sense because they have the whole scene with the lanterns and things.
That's it, the lantern.
The
yeah.
lanterns. Okay, okay, so yeah, totally Rapunzel.
All right,
Tangled.
Tangled. Tangled. Tangled. There Tangled. You
That's
go.
It. Yeah, yeah.
That's it.
Cool. So, you just recently celebrated an anniversary, right? Here at this location.
We did. So we're 3 years.
3 years.
We've been here for a little over 3 years.
Congratulations, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. We started off with five vendors. Five vendors. And that's, I think, three
and
of them.
He was one of the
vendors. Yeah,
right?
There was three of them, but three of them were us. And it was my in-laws and us and someone we reached out to, and they were on board. Like, it was really hard to get people to come in at first because, like, I don't know. And then by the time Christmas hit, it was cool. I was still working ironwork. I'd come in every day, and there'd be a new vendor. We'd have a new vendor. We'd have a new vendor. And so it was really cool. And it's still to this day, like, someone would come in with something random, and I shouldn't say random because it's not random. It's just cool stuff. Uh-huh. And, you know, it still has that flame going.
Right. That's so cool. And as part of that anniversary, the 3-year anniversary, you just recently announced an expansion.
Yes.
Talk to us about the expansion.
So it just kind of happened. Our lease was up and the place next to us opened up. And so we said, all right, well, let's expand. So another 1,800 square feet. We're at 1,500 square feet right now. And we're going to 1,800 square feet right next to us.
So you're doubling in size, basically.
We're over the doubling. Because you think we got the counter and we got the back storage room area here. We don't have that next door. It's just all makerspace.
And you were hinting at the feel or the vibe of that.
We're gonna keep that kind of on the down low. It's gonna be a little different vibe and a little different feel, and it shows that, you know, there's something for everybody, and there is now. Maybe some people just can't see it.
Right.
So we're gonna help them visualize it.
So do you have a timeline on that right now for completion?
Mid-November.
Your anticipation.
My anticipation is mid-November.
Yeah, we walked in.
Wow.
It is walls right now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It's walls right now. There's also the cutting out the concrete wall and stuff like that's going to be a step. But we're a small business. I work during the day and then go over there and
I'm sure it's hard to leave it alone though once you get a project.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's perfect. Coming up perfect time again for that holiday season, those unique gifts, those, you know, well thought out pieces. You know, it's just a great idea.
We're open.
Yeah. Guys, hey Riverside, any other questions for Rico? I mean, I've been taking the time, so.
Oh no, it's cool. I've always wondered about the name.
Made.
Made is obvious, but the way you write it and the way it's written whenever it shows up, it's made, period, shop.
That's my better half.
That's, you know, in that, you know, that's real thing. Well, I mean, I had a duo in the 90s, right? We were called Actual Size, but when we put it out there, it was always small case in parentheses. So when you were mentioned in print or anything, there was a visual thing there that caught your eye and it registered. And of course, that was the first thing that happened with Made. When I saw it, that I recognized and said, there you go. It's, you know, the difference is right there in the name. And it was a good move. A real good move.
That's what I told her.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
And it was her idea, right?
Yes. She's the brains behind the operation.
No, this is... No, I just want to talk about a little bit about what we've talked about the local thing.
Mm-hmm.
And when you buy, well, every purchase you make, if you can, you know, it's really important to try and source your things with local people, independent shops. I mean, of course, you know, Riverside, we have plenty of play. You can go to Best Buy. So, well, some things you can only get in big box stores.
Right.
But when it comes to gifting, when it comes to furnishings, even useful stuff, you know, that I'll see in here. When you buy something from a local vendor, there's just so much more money that stays in our local economy.
Exactly.
Well, on that note, that's something that's really dear to my heart is promoting a local economy. I don't think maybe people don't realize how much when they buy local rather than online or a big box store, the money really stays a lot closer. Even using a franchise, I know there's local franchise owners and stuff like that.
Right.
And I know that, but I was talking to someone who worked at Ralph's, and it was funny because they were manager there, and they're saying when the money comes in, and it's not a thing against Ralph's or anything, but it just like gets deposited into a bank across state lines instantly.
Mm-hmm.
I
sure.
mean, but there are the workers and all that, so sure. I get that. But on a smaller mm-hmm. level, your vacuum repair guy, all these people, these gifts and things that you could buy locally, you know, it's gonna hurt us in the long run if we don't support local, I believe.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And I know you have some ideas going for, you know, maybe building that coalition mm-hmm. a little stronger. And
I think it's just people aren't very aware of mm-hmm. it. And to spend a couple more cents or a dollar more, the outcome in the long run is a thriving community.
Absolutely.
Which is way more healthier than everybody trying to shoot themselves in the foot to save a couple cents on some toilet paper or something, you know?
Yeah, and you know, speaking of thriving in the community, I mean, I have to give you a lot of credit because this store is in a little strip here on Magnolia that it's hard to make something happen here. And you've done really well with that to the point where they're expanding. Now, on top of that, you've brought a really, really valuable community event into existence. I mean, Magnolia Center Marketplace just finished its third year.
Yes.
And it's really, you know, there's nothing else in Riverside like it. It's very unique. And of course, back in the day, you know, we had like Downtown Wednesday Night.
Right.
Downtown, you know, Riverside Partnership put together. You know, and there's a few little farmers markets that go on, but this year it really came into its own as a community event and drawing from all over the city and beyond. And personally, you know, I these are my roots are in Magnolia Center, so it's just wonderful to see that kind of community. Well, I mean, it's activity. It's, you know, you're working to put something back in.
Well, it's one thing that's really cool, and still even walking out there, even the first year I saw it a lot more, but even now you see people walking down the street and they're walking and they go, hey, I haven't seen you in like two, and then they sit there and you'll see, and you'll walk away and you'll come back later and they're still talking there 30 minutes later. And I'd witnessed that they hadn't seen each other or even talked to each other in like 2 years,
mm-hmm.
you know? So it's really cool bringing the community together that way.
Right, the face-to-face awesome. Thing. That's what we always say, you know, because we mention it, you know, every week you have it, you know, we have it on our calendar show. We say, you know, go down there and you're going to see someone you know. Absolutely. And, you know, you bring the dog, you bring the kids.
Yeah,
it's good stuff.
Pet friendly, some good stuff.
Well, that's definitely the one thing about the shop and anything down here is before everybody would think of this area as sadly like, oh, well, I like the Sires, but just the Sires and the Plaza. And now I hear people always go, oh, it's where the Market Night is, or that's where Made is, mm-hmm. you know, and that's something I love hearing, that it's about a local Riverside shop, and the love for this place has really shown lately. And the fact that the city has given you guys so much love, and the fact that I see nothing but a really cool future for Made and for... I gotta point out, too, it smells great in here.
I love this. I haven't worked next door. I think you can say something else.
You know, he could smell horrible, but I walk in here, it smells so nice, and the atmosphere is so nice, the family is so friendly, and it's a beautiful shop, and I gotta point out that it's so well made, and you could take a picture in any spot in the shop, and it'll look cool. It'll look like something that belongs in, like, a TV movie or...
And there's going to be a bunch of things you can look at in that
picture. You can spend easily 2 hours in here just looking around and finding really unique things. Again, one for your family, friends, and holidays.
Right.
But to be honest, let's be selfish. Buy something for yourself. I want a couple of these robots in here, you know?
So cool.
It's a really cool shop, and to come down here and just meet everybody. And if you're in Riverside only once, this is one of the top five places I always recommend.
This is a very Riverside
I tell
shop.
People, go check out the Mission Inn, go check out Tio's Tacos, go check out the Fox, go check out Made. You know, these are the places I want to tell people to go check out, and it's literally become part of the history of Riverside, and everybody's going to love this place for decades to come. And I think your family's going to be here generations and generations, and there's going to be different Maids in different corners of Riverside and corners of your different towns. Because this might be something where it's,
I would never want to see it leave the family. It's going to be like In and Out. They're going to become millionaires, and they're going to have In and Out money.
It's made money.
I'll tell you, it's those candles, man. They're going to make so much money on those candles. They smell so good. But yeah, once again, I want to thank you for making everybody feel welcome and just being so friendly. And everybody at the market night, I've never seen anybody upset. Everybody's having a great time. The food's great. The vendors are great. And the people are great. And he's right. I've seen people who haven't seen each other for 20 years. And they run into each other. And they're crying, smiling, laughing, taking pictures. And they're happy. They have came to this one little spot in Riverside that's really a place where you can stop and meet people. It's community. Not too loud. It's not too loud. It's not too crazy. It's just right.
Yeah, we try and keep it not too loud.
Yeah, trust me. It was me. I turned it down.
Back to nine.
Yeah. Not 11. But awesome. and I thank you guys for coming down, because everybody, please share this. Please tell your friends, because this is the holiday season. Don't. Yes. I'm not going to say which stores not to go to or what online thing not to check out. But hey, if you want to get something cool for your loved ones, your mom, your grandmother, your grandfather, this is the place to come. And they got so many things that represent Riverside that you can always show your love for Riverside just by coming here. And I don't know how I can sell you guys anymore. They haven't given me any money for this.
We're just doing it because we love this guy.
Honestly, we love him. Yeah. And he's a part of the neighborhood, and he's part of Riverside. And I think that he's too humble to admit it, but I think he's really proud of everything that's going on. And, you know, how many awards are you going to win next year? We're going to have to make up new awards just for him.
No, we're completely honored, and with everything, the community, the city, the pit group, the chamber, we get a lot of love, and it really keeps us going, and it's really cool. We're really honored, and most of all the artists and makers. I mean, obviously, we wouldn't be here without them. Right. They're the ones that
Thank you so much for showcasing talent from Riverside that I would never have known about. You know, and it's because of your store and places. Like, even just recently, you were at the Riverside Municipal Auditorium showing off your stuff. And I'm not going to say that there was anybody as great as you guys, but I thought you guys were the best spot in there. Hands down. I stopped back over there. I was like, oh, I like Made. I like everybody else, but Made was just a step above the rest, in my opinion.
And, you know, I was talking... talking about it with...
you got to buy it now.
I know. With my colleague on the way here. You know, my co-host. You've been doing this as long as I can remember. Even as a teenager, even in your early 20s, you were networking people. You were working websites, man. We were doing this thing. This is what you do. And you have made a living out of it. You've thrived on it, and that is so cool.
I like bringing people together. I like it's good. It's community. It's good. Networking and everything's good.
Yeah. Thank you so much for just being the heart of that. Bringing us together today.
It's all because of Rico.
Can we talk about you guys a minute? Because we haven't gone out to our page.
These guys are awesome.
And you have a podcast called The Extraordinary Culture Podcast.
That's right.
And I've seen like three episodes, or listened to three episodes now. And you can find it on iTunes and all the podcast outlets and stuff. And now, do you guys do that here in Riverside? Or
We're all... either Corona or Riverside based. Okay. In Ontario, actually.
Ontario.
So Inland Empire, born and bred, all of us. So we do it. The actual recording happens in Corona.
Okay.
That's where.
But a lot of fun. It usually runs like an hour or so.
Yeah.
And just a lot of great local culture discussions.
Yeah. We're four of us. We've all known each other for 25, 30 years. You know, we're brothers and cousins and best friends from ever. So
yeah,
anytime we get together, it's just us hanging out. We're BSing like
but the totally cool regional vibe.
Yeah,
you know, like Patrick and I, we're a little more hyper local than you guys.
But
really, it's about our region here.
Mm-hmm.
And the IE sort of gets, you know. For years, the IE was sort of the stepchild of LA and Orange County. But
we didn't get no love back.
We've come into our own here. We got our own thing out here.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the cool thing about it. We're not LA. We're not OC. We definitely have our own character out here. And, you know, once again, you know, Rico's a big part of putting that together. You guys doing a podcast, you know, you representing. It's good stuff. So, yeah.
Yeah. Can I talk about you guys a minute? I noticed Patrick's sitting here. He's doing his plugs.
Oh yeah, no, so, no doubt about it. I'm ashamed with self promoter, no, so no. I gotta point this out.
So you brought back Spike and Mike's.
Yes, I have. Yes. Luckily, about a year and a half ago, we did an interview with Spike, and he's a fan of the show,
mm-hmm.
and we've just had a friendship with him. And about 3 months ago, I told Spike, hey, I'd like to do a show at the Fox. Would you let me do it? And he said, yeah, no problem. So we made it happen. It happened within a week, and I went and talked to the Fox. I talked to him, made sure everything happened, and we have a brand new show coming to the Fox for the first time in over a decade and a half.
I remember going to these at UCR back at the Village Theater. Man.
Oh, yeah.
Just watching. Okay, yeah, so yeah. Much good time. Yeah.
So let's talk about real quick. What was some of your favorites?
No Neck Joe.
Love that, dude. First off, he said it off camera and said, No Neck Joe. That's what we want to hear, because anybody who went there knows that the entire crowd, once No Neck Joe came on, 1,000 people would scream, No Neck Joe, real loud.
You know, I'm going to go with Monkey versus Robot, too, though.
That one was
awesome. I loved Monkey versus Robot. Yeah.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
There's so many. I mean, to me, I always think of seeing Beavis and Butthead in South Park there first,
right.
Or Ren and Stimpy. My God, seeing Ren and Stimpy the first time mm-hmm. at the Fox Theater was there. But some of my all-time favorites are coming back. We're going to have Beyond Grandpa, which to me, I just think of that video that's almost cool. Every day. I think it's hilarious. But then that's because I see a lot of Beyond Grandpas around Riverside. There is going to be Home Honey, I'm High, which is a really famous one, an awesome one. There, I'm thinking about them. Oh, my God, which ones are on? Plus, we have kids in the room, so I can't say the titles of a few of them. But we're definitely going to have, I believe, Happy Tree Friends is going to be on there. We're going to have 27 videos on there. It's 90 minutes. And it's going to be, half of it's going to be classic and half of it's going to be brand new. And I asked him if they're going to be as disturbing or sick as in the past. And he said, oh, yeah. He said, worse than Slouch's Funhouse. And I'm like, oh, my God. Then I don't recommend bringing your kids or if something happens.
Yeah, it's an adult show.
It's an adult show, yeah.
Sick and twisted, dude. That's all I got to say.
So that's Friday, November 2nd.
Yes, Friday, November 2nd. Mm-hmm. About, you know, I'd say right now it's about 40 to 50% sold, and I'm really happy.
That's cool.
I went and had a meeting, and I was like, everybody's happy. I'm happy. I'm just so proud to be bringing it back. I just did an interview today with the Press Enterprise, which was really cool. Last Tuesday, we had Spike calling with K-Cal. So we're trying to push it as much, or just get it out there, because I want as many people to hear about it. And it's definitely one of the coolest things to ever come out of Riverside. I mean, they started showing films at RCC, then they moved it over to Fox, and then to UCR, and then they spread it out.
Now, it had its origin in Riverside, correct?
Yes,
yeah,
it started right
there.
There
were two RCC students. Spike and Mike, and they wanted to, they got the idea one day partying, oh man, wouldn't it be cool to get some, you know, cartoons together, you know, and do an animation festival. And
they were doing rock concerts at the time.
Yeah, and this was, you know, late 70s, mid to late 70s, and, you know, you didn't have the internet or anything like that, so to actually get in touch with cartoonists and animators around the world was sort of difficult, but within 2 years of doing this, you know, it was hugely successful, because I went to the first one. That was back in my day. And doing
it was only 40 years ago.
Landis Auditorium, yeah.
Or it's technically now going to be 41 years ago it started.
And it's by the second and third year, they were running out of material. They couldn't find any more animators, any more people. So they were doing so well with the shows, they started investing in animators. So so many of your major animators that do the stuff you see on Adult Swim, on Fox.
Well, the biggest
Pixar.
One is Pixar. They made definitely the biggest.
John Lasseter.
Sense. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They helped finance his projects.
Well, you got the Matt Stone Trey Parker from South Park. They,
yeah.
Their very first time they ever showed that in public, like the original cartoons they did, was there. Mike Judge from Beavis and Butthead.
Right.
All these guys showcased. Even Tim Burton had his very first shorts, Vincent, and I'm spacing out on the other one, Frank and Weenie. Mm-hmm. Those two were shown at the Fox, and that was way back when they were doing the animation, and then they started doing Sick and Twisted right at the tail end of the 80s and the start of the 90s.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when they would have two shows running.
And that's, you know, once again, it's something that's very much Riverside roots that went out to the whole world.
It started one block from RCC at a place called Mellow Manor. And they're doing a documentary right now that should be released next year. It's called Animation Outlaws. And it's got so many different famous people that, you know, started at Spike and Mike's talking about how cool Spike and Mike's was. And I can't wait to see that. And I'm shameless plug once again, me and him are in it.
If they keep us.
They say they keep us, but.
Cutting room floor. Yeah. Oh, well.
Yeah, the director keeps telling us, oh, no, we're keeping you in. It's like, yeah, we'll wait till that day we see it.
We had one day of fame at Patrick's house where they brought the whole film crew and they actually set up, you know, everything right there in El Rancho Relaxo.
And to go right back, it really what it comes down to is I think Spike realizes that more than most people, I have a huge, huge love for Spike and Mike's in animation. I mean, I don't really watch too much TV. I watch cartoons.
Right.
You know, I'm just stuck. I'm 38, and I'm still watching the same things I watched at 18 or 12. And I don't know. It's just me. I'm that way. And I
a lot of Married with Children.
Yes, I love, I'll tell you what. I can tell you about all about Married with Children. It's one of my favorite shows of all. I got to tell people my three favorite shows that were not cartoons were Married with Children. And then recently, I love Arrested Development.
That was great, yeah.
And I love Sunny in Philadelphia. I think that show is amazing. Mm-hmm. But I don't watch much, like, Breaking Bad or any of that stuff. Or I'm trying to think, like, Modern Family. I just don't watch them. I try. I watch a few episodes. I go back to the American Dads and Simpsons and stuff like that, you know. Or
Bob's Burgers.
Yeah, Bob's Burgers or the amazing Rick and Morty and that stuff, you know. And then plus, kids got to grow up on things like SpongeBob and things like that, where, to me, those were much more, like, old Looney Tunes and things I love, so
yeah,
it all goes right back to that Spike and Mike's, because I want to see what the person started with, where they first got their first cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
That's where Spike and Mike is. So whatever you might see this November 2nd, there might be one or two artists in the next couple of years. They're doing a big thing for Netflix or, you know, Walt Disney. You know,
yeah, you never know.
It happens like that. Somebody sees it 2-3 years later, their film is done, and you got something amazing or something awful, you know, because I hate to say it, that happens, but, you know, I'm just really excited. As you can tell, I'm jazzed.
Oh, I can tell.
I mean,
it's so cool.
It's one of those things that I wish I could just, you know, bring everybody there and not have to charge anybody. And then, on a special note, I have asked, as one of the vendors to be there, is Made. And I'm not sure if we finished all the stuff yet, but I'm going to find a way to get them in there. I don't care how. If not, we're just going to bring this here, and we're going to have this in the lobby right behind, because I want to make sure that Made is definitely shown off inside that lobby.
We're working on some. We're working on it.
It's not done deal, but it might happen, you know. If not, then we'll have him there, and we'll have him greet you and say, hey, here's Made stuff. And, you know, because we know there's going to be at least 500 locals there, so... And then on top of that, I don't know what else I can say about it. I'm proud. We didn't ask Rico. Did you ever go?
No, I did not. I'm sorry. Yeah, so I was just kind of, I thought you were going to ask. I was like, I had the opportunity
was busy
a couple
networking.
Times.
He was
busy going to see the Reverend Horton Heat.
He was managing the Grays. What
are you talking about? Oh, yeah. He had bands.
Yeah, I did. And music was my thing.
That's how I met him, actually, is through networking with bands.
Grace,
yeah.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah.
Good very cool.
Friends of mine, they had their own band, and I said, let me try and start and get you some gigs, and it just kind of kept going.
Right. See that? You stick with that, you probably would have made a lot of money.
You can make money on your friends.
That's like a friend of mine, he wanted to be a cop. He says, I don't want to be a cop, though, in this town. I don't want to bust my friends, you know. On a side note, too, about music, I forgot there is going to be music for the first hour of this, where I'm going to showcase four local artists. And,
sweet.
I'm really happy about that. We're going to have Stephanie Diane Moore start the first 15 minutes, Cadillac Phil the second. Then we're going to have Gino Mateo, one of the best blues artists to ever come out of Riverside.
Another guy from Riverside all over the world.
All over the
yeah.
world.
Yeah.
And then the finish out the music part of the show, Donita Lang Smith. And it's going to be naughty music.
She
from
is amazing.
Your grandma, basically. So.
Yeah, Donita's amazing.
And so I'm really happy to do that. They wanted me to put an intermission. I said, no, let me put some music at the start. And we're going to have a great time. It's going to be a big show. And I'm going to definitely invite you guys, give you some tickets. And
awesome.
Couple
shit.
Tickets to your fans, so some of the people will figure something out, you know.
We'll have the Hey Riverside table set up too and do some live stuff, so you guys
awesome.
Got to come
yeah,
by.
Yeah.
We got two tickets here hidden in the store.
They still have two tickets. I'm going to give them another two, so that there's four tickets somewhere in the store, so you got to find them.
Yeah.
Oh.
I know where one is, and then...
Oh, very cool.
Well, I'm going to have to get
I can't them. Look, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to have
don't
to... I literally do have some tickets ready to give to them, so...
Well, then we got four tickets hidden in the store.
Yeah, so you
got
to come down to Maine. There might even be
under
six.
My seat right now.
I know. Yeah, I might tape them. You know what? To be honest, we probably will tape one under here. So if you watch this, you better get down here early and ask if the tickets are still under here or something. There, if you watch to the end, you got a clue.
Right, there you go.
That's your prize.
That's going to be this. I'll add an extra pair. So now there will be six here.
Okay.
So boom, yeah. We want to get you down here to Made and support it. But also, don't just come down here for tickets. Bring money or your credit card.
And your shopping list for Christmas.
Exactly.
So you buy some from Made, you get free tickets. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's the way to go.
I love this place.
Awesome.
I got to say, once again, come down here, get ready, spend some time here.
Yes, please do.
You know, don't expect to be here for 10 minutes, because 10 minutes isn't enough.
No,
you got to have at least 20, 30, 40.
You got to really take your time with it.
And, yeah.
And I mean, you know, just sitting here, man, I'm seeing new stuff I haven't seen before.
There's these giant cups for coffee, in case you really need the really big cup of coffee. Is that
for rain cross ones?
A rain cross nightlight.
Ooh.
Right?
We got a couple of them.
Yeah.
And you know what's really scary is I think we might be running out of time on their show. Are we still got time?
We still got a lot.
Okay, I was worried. I was like, uh-oh, are we running? How long's your show's normally? Like 20 minutes and we're like,
you know what? If we do a special edition of this one and just lease
room, cutting room floor,
we do it.
Yeah. See, we're going to be in the cutting room. Really, this is the Rico version and here for the long version. You know?
We will start to wrap up, though, just so we don't run out of time. Thank you. Thank you, Patrick.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hey,
thank you,
Ralph. Nice to meet
thank
you.
Thank you,
guys. As always, thank you for
Rico,
your sponsorship.
You
thank you.
Rico.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Xavier.
So
Xavier.
Don't forget to check out the Hey Riverside podcast if you're listening on Extraordinary Culture.
And if you're listening on the Hey Riverside, please check out the Extraordinary Culture podcast. And get down to Made and check it out if you haven't been here yet.
All right, everybody. And last but not least, dun, dun, dun.
Your promo.
All right, had to do it.
Catch
see you guys later.
Time.